Hey there, welcome to this course on numerical methods using MATLAB. This is module 1, simple calculation using MATLAB, and we will learn mathematical functions. Now let us try to solve this equation which has this input value, and we can write a program for this like this. We can give a value of a for variable 3, value of 5 to variable 5, yeah, I'm giving semicolon after each variable. C has a value of minus 3. And I can write a function for these equations like this. This is minus b minus a divide by in bracket, because here this function is completely divided by this one. So this should be in the bracket. It will be b plus, again in bracket, b plus a, b plus a, and this b plus a divided by, again, this function's c into a, c asterisk a, and this is my function. So now, if I enter 0 here, I will get value of z as minus 5.729. There are many mathematical functions which are available to use in MATLAB. To see those, we must visit MathWorks website. And if we visit MathWorks website, if you go to the support, and in this support, you can get help about documentation. Click over here. And once you are on this page, if you click on this function MATLAB, you can see all the functions this MATLAB has developed. Now, since we are interested in mathematical functions, we will click on this mathematics, and we'll be able to see elementary mathematical function, exponential logarithmic function, complex number, and even trigonometric functions over here. So if we click on the sine function, it gives what syntax we should use and what type of output we will get. So here y is input and x is input, and it gives a lot of information. So and when should whenever you are facing any problem with using any function, just visit mathworks.com and search for that function and how to use it properly. Now let us try to use the sine function. To use that one, use sine, and we have z value above. If we enter this, we will get a value of sine of z. Now let us try to solve some of these equations here. Here, first equation is x is equal to sine of 20 divided by 180 into pi. Pi we can write in small p I. So it will take up the value of pi, which is 3.14. And this will solve this equation and we'll get the value of x. So next equation is cos x minus sine of x. Cos of x, it should be in bracket, minus sine of x value. We will get value of 0.667. Now if we want to solve some exponential formula, suppose for example y is equal to x raised to the power 6, this we can do by typing it y is equal to x. We can use this sign, raised to the power 6, and enter. We'll get value of y. And if we want to use exponential, we have this exponent exp in bracket, this should be a log of 20, bracket complete. So you can see which bracket is for complete switch brackets by just clicking on here, and you will see some underscore over there. And in next video, we'll learn about vectors. Thank you.